Right, well, this is too corporate for me, this mic being on here, so let me take this off and let's get involved. Okay, cool. So I have a script, but I don't want to read the script because that gets boring. I'm just going to go off the presentation and what I know. And before I start, yeah, I saw Miss Alexander in Dubai. Now, for you guys that don't know, imagine seeing your teacher, head of department, in swim trunks on a lazy river. Do you know how awkward it was? But anyway, we're not here to talk about that at all. Let's move on. Right, cool. So... Yeah. The gym. No, joking. Anyway, right, so I'm going to begin with, it was a lovely intro. My name is Cecil G. Thomas, and I get to do this quite often at football clubs. I do workshops and talks, so it's an honour to be here today, and I owe so much to the school for where I am today. So I'm going to begin with, when I was in school, and once I left school, I realised a lot about life, and I really wished that there was a life class. Like, I just thought... school should have, in the educational system, a class based on life, like taxes and what you need to do after you leave and moving out, mortgages and stuff. So this opportunity that I have today, I want to talk about, not that, because that can be boring at times, but life. So we're going to do a life class. So yes, and I'm sorry there is a learning objective as it's, we're in a school sort of situation. So yeah, I want you guys to understand that anything, you can achieve anything, basically. That is what I want you guys to get from this. You can achieve anything. And I know it sounds a bit preachy and corny, but through my experience, honestly, you really can, and I'm gonna talk about it. So there's gonna be gems dropping throughout the whole presentation, so be aware of the little gem sign. That's me dropping some bombs, and I want you guys to make sure you take in what I say, so just be aware. Cool, so let's move forward, let's go. So, in life, I have my clicker. Sorry, I'm so sorry, I'm being a diva again. I've got the clicker, don't need to do that. Okay, cool, so in life, I believe that everyone is just figuring it out. Parents sometimes get into a situation and just figuring it out. Like, you don't know what to do. Teachers, I'm sure you go through it. I go through it. Students, you're going to go through it a lot in your life, maybe in year 11 when you're doing options in year 9. You're just figuring it out. This is how it looks. Oh, it went. Oh, there it is. There we go. So, yeah, you know, Pulp Fiction. So, this was me. This is everyone. Nowadays, everyone's just figuring it out. That is how it is. We all go through it. So I'm going to talk about the situation where I was figuring it out, but then led to a great path in life and what I do now for a living. And talking about path, actually, let's go back to where it all began. So I went to this school, my big beanhead over here. Here we go. Look at that. Here we go. Always full of smiles. That was me. There was one year that I'm very proud of was when I got to be the prospectus, got to be the face of the school. Imagine that. Cecil G. You know, Reigate, I was walking around the streets like, yeah, that's me in the school, it's me in the school. So, yeah, this is a very proud moment. My parents also really were very proud. And I bring this up because it was a big moment for me and it meant so much to me that the school allowed me to do this. And just a little story, I didn't get into Reigate School straight away. So in year 6, I got accepted to Warwick. Boo. But, yeah, that's bad. So I got accepted into Warwick, but my mum was having none of it. And she was like, I'm not sending you there. I still live locally. I live up the road. So I'm not sending you there. So we appealed me getting into Warwick, and it took, I think, 2 terms, and I finally got into Reigate School, and it was the proudest moment ever, because I knew so much about the school, it was so close to me, I had all my friends here, so yeah, I actually owe a lot to them, and I just wanted to touch on that. Okay, so moving forward, here we go. Oh, I had to add this photo, I'm so sorry. Right, so this is my favourite photo ever, this is me at prom. So all the year 7s, 11s, if you're doing prom, you've got to try and top this photo, okay? I use this in every presentation, because... Yeah, I know, I mean, it's a bit of a confidence boost, but I just love this one. All right, let's move on. Okay, cool. So I'm going to talk about my most significant years. So that was year 9 and year 11, okay? So personally, I think they're the most important years, and that, to me, that's they were in my life. So going back, when I started in year 7, I was put in set 2 for everything. So I was middle set for absolutely everything. And year 7 is how it is. You go into the school, it's a new place, you meet loads of new people, you try and make new friends. Year 8, you kind of got used to what's going on, but you're still finding your feet. In year 9, a lot of my friends were in set 1, and I wanted to be in set 1. I was like, why am I not in set 1? I'm smart. So I had to work really, really hard. So I did that, and I proved to myself that I could work hard. And I think that's very vital. Like, working hard is the most important thing that you guys all need to remember. Hard work beats everything. So I worked really hard, and luckily I got awarded Gifted and Talented, which was a school scheme where if they recognize a student in the in their year, or in a year, doing really well, they'll offer them gifted and talented. So I moved up in English, maths, and geography. Geography was linked to history, so technically it's four sets, but it's being ego and arrogant, me talking about that. So three sets. So I moved up, and it was a great success. I moved up, I got awarded gifted and talented. Now, I'm about to drop a gem. Here we go, cool. So, what you didn't realize, when I got awarded gifted and talented, my award was to go to the weekend school of Italia Conti, which is basically a performing arts school that hire out Reigate School Saturday and Sunday. Now the school offered to pay for me to go there, okay? So I got a full scholarship basically to go there every weekend. Now at first, I was like, no way, no way. Imagine me, cool kid on the prospectus trying to be a footballer and you want me to go and do ballet. Like, no, it wasn't happening. So it took a couple weeks. Miss Hill or Wendy was on my back. She was on my back. I can't even tell you. She's like, just go, you'll love it. In the end, my mum bought me leotards and ballet shoes, and she was like, you're going. And I was like, okay, well, I'm going because I live in that house and I want to live in that house forever. So, yeah, so I went, and it kind of, at first, it was different, but it actually changed my life and it led to the end. So I'm going to keep going forward. So year 11 now. Year 11 is the time where, like I said, you are figuring it out. So I had this moment in my life. Again, like I've just, please work, come on. There we go, the Pulp Fiction guy. So in year 11, you do your GCSEs, and then you're like, well, what do I do now? Do I go to college? Do I do something different? Let me tell you what I had on my plate. I got into Brit School. I got a 75% scholarship to Italia Conti main school, and I was offered a football professional contract at Crawley Town. So I had to make a big decision, and what's overlooked a lot in life is the decisions kids have to make at 16 years old, right? Because you're basically, I'm not saying you're determining your future, but it's a big step into your life. So I sat and pondered for a while, but going to college or dancing or being a footballer and getting paid, it was, for me, an obvious answer. However, guys, listen to your parents. Listen, I know it sounds crazy. My mum said, you should do dance. She goes to Brit School because that is perfect. We went to the open day, she's like, this is you, this is perfect. I completely ignored her because I was like, well, she don't know what she's talking about. Funny thing, she does. The parents do, and so do teachers. So listen to them. Sorry, I hope I get my tip. So listen to them because honestly, I then left and became a footballer and I didn't enjoy, I didn't enjoy my time and I left football. We'll get onto that. So the reason why this is up here, if you want something, go get it, period. Okay, now this is something I live by. I learned a lot about myself through this statement. So when I was on trial at Crawley Town, this is the club I signed for in year 11, I was offered day release. So day release is basically where the football club will ring the school and say, look, can we have Cecil for the day? And we'll send him back the next day, but can we have him for the day to train? So I did that, and I did that a lot, but it was during the time of my GCSE exam. So basically around the time, I don't know if it is now GCSEs, yeah, so about now, I was going to train and miss important days of school or revision. Now, this is when I learned that I can do whatever I want and I can smash it. Because basically, I missed out on so much revision time, but I was determined to get good grades and sign a professional contract. And I did. Got really good grades, and then I signed at Crawley Town. There's another gem. I signed at Crawley Town. So we'll move forward. Ooh, this clicker. There we go. So, oh, no, don't go. Okay, cool. So I signed at 16, I signed a contract at Crawley Town. So I was there for 2 years. I don't want to bore you guys all with a story. We'll save it for another time, hopefully. So I was a footballer for 2 years. I left football, I did a lot of shoots. So Marcus Rashford's, for Man United, I'm his body double. So I do a lot of his adverts, all the campaigns he does for Adidas and Nike. It's mainly me, and they just superimpose his face onto mine, or he'll be there. So at this shoot, we did an advert, and he was there, and long story, but we'll get to that. So another time. So I left football after having not the best experience. I fell out of love with the game, and I left. So I want to do something different, but what do I do? I was in that place where I was like, what do I do now? The school realized I like to dance, so they gave me that scholarship. So I was like, well, maybe I should try something different. Maybe I should try dancing or performing. I did enjoy it, but I wasn't any good. All I could do was all the stuff you guys watch on Fortnite and on TV. So the Millie Rock, you know, the Fortnite dances, all of this. This is all I could actually do. I couldn't actually dance, the floss. I've been completely honest. That's all I did. I did all the crazes. So in the program, it says Wendy saw me and a big crowd of people watching me dance. I was probably doing the Soldier Boy because I used to love that. So I couldn't really dance. So I was like, it's a big risk, but I believed I could do it because I proved it to myself that I could work hard, get good grades and be a professional footballer. So I can do, surely I can do other stuff. So anyway, not making it in football, not making it as a footballer was the best thing that never happened to me because it led me right here. And I get to do this and talk to people all over the world and all over the country. And I get to do amazing, amazing shoots and jobs, which we'll get to. Cool. So I was a gem. So I was in the Daily Telegraph. This is where it kind of all started. I was in the Daily Telegraph in my second year of Italia Conti. And they did a story about me, about my transition from football to performing. And from there, I realized, like, wow, this is a good story. And it's getting press, so I must be doing something right. So then I started doing dance jobs and became a dancer. So here's me. This is me in the ballet leotard, which I'm actually proud of. Yeah. Now, doing flips because I love to do flips and that's what I really enjoy. I do flips when I perform and dance. And when I went to college and I went to Italia Conti main school, a lot of the students said to me, they're like, you can't be a, like, you're not going to make it. You're not going to be a dancer. How are you going to be a dancer? You've never done any exams. I've done no dance exams to this day, none of them. And you've just started dancing from like properly from like the age of 18. So how are you going to be a dancer? And I got that quite a lot, to be fair, because I hadn't done it since I was a baby. However, I proved them wrong, as we're going to see right now. So I featured in a little mixed music video, but I'm not going to show you that one. I'm going to show you this performance from my second year at Move It. Enjoy. Cool. Let's go.
Say goodbye, that's what you told me once. So many times we've made our peace. But this is love, I'll never give you up. I know you'll always come home to me. Like a river always running, I keep losing you. Like a fire always burning, I'll be here for you.
Come!
Okay, cool. So yeah, that was, oh, stop! Oh, that was nice. yeah, that was in 2017, so that was 2 years ago. And like I did say at the start, like, I honestly couldn't dance. I know you think going to the weekend school might have trained me for it, but honestly, going to full time is completely different. I didn't understand about pointing your toe and having your leg, like, out here. Do you know what I mean? So it was a lot for me to learn, and I really had to work hard. But this is what I say, you can do absolutely anything. Like, that was me being a feature against all the kids that started dancing at this small. So just remember that. I finished doing dance, but I was enjoying dance, doing a lot of amazing jobs. And then I was like, I kind of want to act. Like, I really want to be an actor. Like, that would be a dream. And people were like, well, acting is one of the most difficult industries to get into, Cecil. And I was like, well, so was football and so was dance. So, I mean, I'm sure we can give it a go. So I did. And then I want to show you quickly an advert, which I did. There's currently an advert on TV right now, the Currys and PC World one. I don't know if you've seen it. It was on last night at Love Island. I'm just showing off now. Let me shut up. Watch this advert. This is me acting and dancing as well. So here we go. So yeah, that was that, and that was, oh, thanks. It's so awkward. It's bad. I should have added more videos. I actually enjoy it. I should have added more videos. But anyway, so that was me acting and dancing, and yeah, so I proved myself. I was like, okay, cool, that I can do that. I can act in front of camera. And since then, I've done a lot of acting jobs, done a lot of adverts, there's currently one at the moment. So yeah, so I proved that to myself, and then I kind of graduated from college. So I graduated last year, September. And I was like, okay, I do so much things, I really enjoy it. Let's try something different. Why not, Cecil? Prove yourself again. See if it actually works what you're saying, like the mentality and proving yourself right. So I wanted to start doing presenting now and hosting, so like this. So I was like, okay, how do I go about that? And I told people, like, I want to try presenting because it's more about personality and stuff, and I feel like I'll be okay at it. Those doors getting slammed in my face left, right, and center. They were saying, you didn't train in it. You went to a Taliconti to train in musical theater for 3 years. Why are you going to be a presenter? That's not going to work. No one's going to take you serious. So then I just kind of, I laughed at that and said, well, I presented for New Balance, Kipco. I do all the race days, Champions Days with ITV Racing. And I was with Anthony Joshua with Sky VIP. So I was like, well, it can be done. So I'm just proving to you guys, it can be done. I mean, I'm listing off my CV right now, but I'm just saying, like, there was a lot of people that just, there's always going to be doubters, and that is what I was just like, well, if I believe I can do something, put my mind to it, I really can. And all of you can do it. Same with like GCSEs, all the exams and work and life. It's just about mindset. We're going to move forward. Okay, cool. This is where it gets a bit crazy, a bit deep. Okay, whoa. Okay, you're a jack of all trades, Cess, master of none, basically. I get told this so much. I mean, every day, if not. You're a jack of all trades, Cecil, and this is my reaction every time. It's like, oh, give it rest. Let me tell you, this is why I have this face, and let me tell you my answer. I've now learned to answer this question. I'm so proud of myself. I feel so smug. So people say to me, you're a jack of all trades, Cecil, master of none. And I was like, so why do you say that? Like, where's that come from? Like, where have you got that from? And they were like, well, you do a load of good stuff, like really well, but you don't have one focus on anything. And I was like, okay, so I do things really well, but a load of different things really well. So that means I'm a master of doing loads of things really well, right? And then this is their reaction. You know, we give them back my favorite little gift. They stand there stumped and they're like, well, he might be right there. He is a master of doing a lot of things really well. So that was my response to it. And I'm really proud of that response. And what I also want to say is you can do anything that you put your mind to and believe in it. So you were given a name when you was born. Everyone was. You were given a name. You never chose your name, but your name was given to you. And people told you that was your name. And people refer to you by that name. So if they learn that from someone else, then surely if you believe you're something, then you can do it. So that's what I'd like to say. And anything is possible, okay? We're in a world of you can do whatever you want. Listen, Donald Trump's the president. I mean, you can do whatever you want. So you can do whatever you want. Anything's possible. And look at like the complete difference. So I want you guys to always remember that, okay? Please. And before I go, sorry, I've spoke for a lot, but okay. Before I go, I just got a little message that I was working with some people this week, and they wanted to give you a little message. So to you guys, Reigate School, you may know who they are.
Reigate School, I just wanted to say, make sure you guys listen to Cecil, and if you do, you never know, you could end up like this.
Okay, cool. So yeah, so basically, I didn't know who that was until I worked with them, but I know the generation of children, that's their YouTubers, but to me, I'm a TV guy, but they're YouTubers and they're like the most successful YouTubers, and they said they would love to do a message. So that's for you guys. And I know how hard you worked through school, and you're gonna get awarded today for all your hard work. And we appreciate it, myself and the school. So thank you. And parents, thank you for listening. And before I go as well, sorry, I keep adding on, parents, you're so important to the children's lives and your sons or daughters. I just want to make that very clear. My mum was on my back, and all the teachers will say, Wendy's an advocate for this. My mum was so disciplined and so strict with me. When I say I got good grades and I signed a professional football contract, it's because my mum would have killed me otherwise. So that's why. So you're very important. Just make sure they are focused and they know what they want to do, and just help them alongside. Because honestly, if it wasn't for my mum, I wouldn't be standing here today, because she literally helped me all the way through. So yeah, thank you so much for listening, and we're going to get some awards. Thanks.